What's up, family? It's your boy Javert, like air. Just trying to spread the love like butter, man. I'm sitting here at this table and the Lord just put something on my spirit, which is simply the embodiment of grace. I feel like to some extent, we as a people have lost sight of the true meaning and understanding of grace. And I'm just sitting here wondering to myself, like, wow, how easy is it to become completely and entirely codependent on grace? I remember there was a point in my life where I could sit back and just reflect and say, yeah, I was there where I was completely codependent on grace. I to some extent, expected God to come through for me, you know, in which every case you should expect God to come through for you. But when you sin, you should never move forward sinning, thinking that the Lord is just going to continue to cover you. No grace. When we understand what grace is in essence unmerited favor. When God does something for you that you don't deserve, when he saved you and he died on the cross, we didn't deserve that immense power of grace and love that he had over the earth. And this message has been really, really on my heart. I just want to talk to you guys really quick and just so we can grasp a better understanding of grace in its entirety. But I want you to just capitalize this thought. Grace is not earned. What do I mean by that? Grace is not earned. Grace excludes merit. We must constantly remind ourselves that humanity is not deserving of salvation, that we are not deserving of salvation. I'm not deserving of salvation. And every person that watches this video, in essence, you are not deserving of salvation. No one can earn or pardon by works of human merits. So we see that if such were the case, we could boast regarding our redemption. However, that is not possible. And so we see in Ephesians, I believe it's Ephesians 2, 8 to 9, it says, even if one were able to perform everything that God commands us to do, he still must regard himself as an unprofitable servant. And that's such a humbling scripture to me, because the Bible teaches us that we can't obtain perfection. I mean, it's impossible to be perfect. There's only one man who ever walked on this earth who was perfect, and that was Jesus. But yet the scriptures tell us that we must strive after perfection. And so when this scripture spoke to me, and then it went on to say that even if it was possible to do all these things, that you have to regard yourself as an unprofitable servant, it means that you yourself cannot gain anything without the grace and the love of God over your life. That was Ephesians 2:8, I believe. Ephesians 2:8, where as in Luke 17:10, Jesus actually then he teaches our sins has put us head over heels in debt when it comes on to the redemption that he has given the world, that no person has the innate ability to liquidate the obligation that they have to Jesus. And so we see that when I read that scripture, it was so real to me to know that there was just no way that we can pay back what the Lord had done for us on Calvary. There was literally nothing you can do. It pretty much tells us that in that thought, that there was nothing that you can possibly do to earn your salvation, earn your way into heaven, to pay back Jesus for the blood that he shed on the cross. Then it raises another thought. Then how do we commit ourselves to him? The only way to commit ourselves to him is to live the life and to give our heart and our mind and our body and our spirit, give our whole heart to Jesus, so that he can start us new and make us afresh and break us over. In Matthew, I think it's verse chapter 18, 24 to 27, it talks about just that. It says when the concept of is truly grasped and it teaches us and we understand that proper doctrine, we learn that service to the Almighty God will flow with a freshness and a zeal that invigorates the soul. It's something that you've never experienced before. That is a feeling that I long after every single day. It's just a new freshness, a new anointing, a new mindset, so that I can walk into life every single day with a different head on my shoulders, one better than the day before. And I want to say this, you know, doubtless a failure to fathom the true significance of grace is the reason why many believers are so spiritually lethargic. Thank you, Holy Spirit. That was so powerful, because we learned that people today have become so weak in our spirit that when we're confronted with trials and tribulation and struggle and adversity, we're easily conquered. You know, like I made in that my last video, you know, we need the struggle. One of the points that, you know, I pray that every person that watches it gets is that you need to go through something so that your spirit can be tested and tried and true, so that when confrontation meets you again, which it will, that you are able to withstand it. That when the Lord allows you to be thrown into the fire again, that you're able to withstand it. That when the devil comes in like a flood and that it doesn't come up to your neck, that you will be able to withstand the wiles of the enemy. You know, it is imperative that you strengthen your faith, that you strengthen your spirit, that you get to a place to where you need to be. But understand one thing, it is by grace through faith that we are saved, not by works or nor by merit. And so that there is nothing that you can do that can earn your spot with God, if you want to put it like that. I just want to leave you guys with that, man. I was just sitting out here and that was really on my heart, man. It's just grace is misunderstood. In fact, I'll say this and then I'll go. I'm coming out with a piece in a couple weeks. In the first line of that poem, it starts off like this. It says, I feel like we take God for granted. Just think about that. Because truly, deep down inside my heart, I feel like I've taken God for granted. And when I sit back and think, spiritually, I might be in a better place than others. How many other people may have taken God for granted? Wow. That'll sit with anybody. Anyways, y'all, just wanted to kind of share that was on my heart. And just keep doing what you're doing, man. Keep encouraging in the faith. Keep pressing through. Again, this is your boy, Javere Like Air. You know, get at me. Chop it up. Got any comments? Leave it below, man. I'd love to hear what you guys got to say. Just keep spreading the love like butter. God is faithful. He won't put on you more than you can bear. Just know that there's a life better than the one that you're living right now. But continue to chase God. All right, though. Peace. I am